Hello explorers and welcome to another video. And today I'm gonna talk a little bit more about how to build TensorFlow on Windows. So this will be somewhat of a June update. I've spent a couple of weeks trying to build TensorFlow on Windows, and I learned a lot of things and I figured out a lot of stuff that could be good for you to know. And I actually got TensorFlow for Windows built once with the release 1.1. Sadly, I've not been able to build any of the other newer builds. And in Windows, you are still able to install TensorFlow as a pip package without building it yourself. The GPU version might not work for you, and that's why we are trying to build it ourselves and also to get a newer version than the actual release version. But using this method we're going to talk about today will work fine to build your JNI libraries for Java if you want to run those on Windows. So first off, one thing that I found is this GitHub project made by Microsoft, which is quite nice, which will remove everything that is installed by Visual Studio, because Visual Studio will actually leave a lot of stuff behind when we uninstall it. So this Visual Studio uninstaller will actually remove all the registry keys and all the other things in your system that you won't be able to remove yourself. You might be required to go in and delete the left behind directories and so on, but no keys will actually point to anything in your system, and that's really good if you want to do a clean reinstall of stuff on your system. And to start this off, we need to download a lot of stuff to build TensorFlow. First off, we need a compiler. So you can actually either use the Visual Studio 2017, the MS Build package, or the C++ Build Tools from 2015. So this, the last one is what I have done, because it will actually be less impact on your system, will install less. And Basil likes it more. It will, if you install it in the standard directories, Basil will pick it up just like that and just work with it. And the other ones, you have to do a little bit more configuration to actually get them to run, but it's possible. Other things that you need to download is Python. Very important to know about both Python and MSys2, which is another requirement, is that you need to download them for your system. So in my case, I run on a 64-bit system, so I need the 64-bit version of both Python and MSys2, or else things will be really strange. It will work somewhat, but it will break in some case. So if you're on a 64-bit system, keep to those packages, and if you're on a 30-bit system, then keep to those packages. So you really need to separate yourself. You can't have some 64 and some 32, and you can't actually use the wrong packages on the wrong platform. So keep that in mind. Next up, we need to go to the Basil build Git repository and fetch one of the releases. The newest release that I found there was 0.5.1, but I saw also that I built 0.5.2, but I haven't actually uploaded it to the GitHub, so that will probably get there soon. Next up, you need to go and fetch the CUDA libraries from NVIDIA. So you get the CUDA download and the CUDNN download, and that package is required you to log in and actually make an account with them. It's not really something that will spam your email or anything like that. They just want to keep track on which people are using their graphic drivers for TensorFlow or others such machine learning purposes. So That's required. It's behind a login wall, but you just need to log in and tell them why you want this. And next up, we build Basil. So after we have downloaded a distribution from the releases page, we will unpack that into a directory, and then we will run pacman to get git, gcc, curl, zip, unzip, and set a lib development. We will export a bunch of variables into our environment to set the work dir and the sh command and your Visual Studio implement install, and also Python. So you will put those paths into your system, and depending on where you install them, then you need to change these paths. And then you run compile to actually do the first run of the dist package, where you build Basil, the simple version. And after that, you run compile with the compile and then the actual built version of Basil. And then when you do that, you will build Basil with Basil in order to get a fully packaged Basil version that you can actually build TensorFlow on. And if you do that, it also will make your builds faster. So it's a good thing to do. And next up, we clone the TensorFlow repository, and you can also check out the release 1.1 as I did. I haven't been able to test all the other ones fully. I had a lot of work just to get one build working, and I really wanted to get this video out, so I stopped there. And after you have checked out this version of TensorFlow, you enter that directory, you do pacman to install patch and protobuf, stuff that you need to work with. I'm not sure that you actually need protobuf, but patch you need. Protobuf is something that when you build a wheel package, it might ask you for that command. But that error should not be any problem to you. And then you install these pip packages. So here you will actually get the protobuf Python package. You have that binary or binding. And after you have installed NumPy wheel and protobuf, you will also set up a lot of paths, where your Python binary is, where your Python library path is, and then we have these Basil work, dir, sh, Visual Studio, and Python again. So those are the ones that you set up earlier when you built Basil. But if you run this over and over and take down your console, it's good to just copy paste these in and start running again. And then you point out your CUDA path and the CUDNN install path. And this is just so you don't have to enter those when you actually configure the TensorFlow build. And in my case, I also set some paths to the CUDA bin directory, so it can find the NVIDIA compiler, NVCC, I think it's named. And also where Python is installed, so it finds python.exe, and also where Basil is outputted. In my case, it was Basil 1.5.1-1 was my directory and the output. So it actually finds the Basil exe, so it can run those. So you extend your path with a few extra. And then we will configure our TensorFlow build. We will answer a lot of questions. In my case, I answered no for everything except for CUDA, where I answered yes, and then I just pressed enter for all the next choices, because those will be set up for me. But when I come down to this additional compute capability significantly increases your build time and binary size, I actually just tell it to use 6.1 because my graphics card is using the feature 6.1. And you can go to this developer NVIDIA CUDA GPUs to know which features your graphics card is actually supporting, so you can put the right number in and also get less build time and also have a smaller binary. And then I just says no to everything else, so I don't get any extras. I set some build parameters. These are required in order to tell TensorFlow which CPU architecture you are building on and what is the host CPU. So these are two ways to tell what kind of system are you running on. So if you set these and then run the build pip package, you will get this build pip package executable that you can use to build your pip package. Sadly, on Windows, some of the linking isn't done during this process, so you get nothing in your build pip package run files directory. So in my case, I actually copy all the files using this command, copy preserved links from Basil TensorFlow in the TensorFlow directory all the way to Basil bin TensorFlow tools pip package build pip package run files, and that will copy all those files over there, so I have the actual files that I need inside of my will package. And then I will run this command that TensorFlow has built for me in order to package my pip package, and then I install that will package in order to get TensorFlow on my system. Last but not least, you have the command for building your JNI files for Java bindings. So you get a jar file that you can bind into your Java application, and also an SO file that you will rename to a DLL file in order to have an include of TensorFlow, so you have all the bindings to your TensorFlow installation. So in my case, you run this build again, the previous options will still be required, and then TensorFlow and lib TensorFlow JNI as the two packages you want to build, and that will create stuff inside of your Basil build TensorFlow Java directory. And from there you copy the lib TensorFlow jar file, and that is something that you bind into your application, as I said, and then you copy this lib TensorFlow JNI SO to TensorFlow JNI in the directory where you have your JNI files, and then you need to include those when you run your Java application in order to get TensorFlow capabilities in your Java application. So this is pretty much what I wanted to go through today, and the big things that I have actually struggled with is that I had different versions of both my MSys2 and my Python installation. Another thing that I had a really hard time was that I installed Python 3.5.1 or 3.6.1. It was a 3 installation, but that didn't work for me because there are a lot of places in the TensorFlow code where it actually looks if your Python installation is 3 or higher, and then it will run some extra steps. But on Windows, that flag isn't set, so it will not know what the major version of your Python installation is on Windows, which means that those functions that is required for Python 3 are not run and will break your build. So when I found that out, I just uninstalled Python 3 and installed Python 2.7.1, and everything built and worked fine after that. So that was a lot of headache just to figure that one out. And during all of these installation and using different build tools, I also found that if you install either the Visual Studio or any of the other compilers in a custom directory, then you actually need to go into the TensorFlow installation and find where it looks for your VS vars all dot bat file and edit that file so it actually will find your bat file in your installation, because it has a lot of pre-computed things that it actually looks at in the path in order to figure out how it should find that file. And if some of those triggers aren't there, it will not find the file. So my simple workaround was actually just go into this configuration file and add my direct path to this bat file, because that bat file will actually set up the full environment for Visual Studio, so the rest of the build process will work. So that's what I've been working on for a couple of weeks, and yeah, I'm really happy that I got it built finally. And I will continue to look into this and have another update probably the next month if I figure out how to build newer releases, and also if I find an easier way to both install and build a TensorFlow package. Because I think this way to install a TensorFlow package is still a bit convoluted and a bit strange and hard. I've been looking into the CMake way of building TensorFlow as well, but it both have a lot of restrictions. For now, you have a lot of options that or operators that is not available in the CMake's build, and you also can't build the JAR implementation through the CMake build, and I haven't actually got CMake working on my machine either, so there's a lot of hurdles before you actually get a good CMake build. But hopefully in the future, if CMake is a good way to build it, then I'm very hopeful that I will create a good implementation that you can build with CMake. The really bad thing about how you build it today is actually Basil, because Basil, as I've said before, is at the moment on 0.5.1, and so much in the Basil build is experimental and badly written for Windows, so you have to do a lot of manual work and figuring out to actually run Basil. So hopefully when Basil stabilizes and gets to 0.1, we will have a lot easier build process for TensorFlow. So I hope you like this video, I hope you learned something today, and I hope to hear from you in the comment section. Subscribe if you haven't done that yet, and I really hope to see you in the next video.